Wes here with Restore Your Jordans and More. I have a project today that's not going to be your normal shoe business video, but we're going to go outside today. We're going to do a restoration outside, not necessarily a restoration, but an actual build. We're going to build a deck. So come back and check out my project, how it's going.
Figured out the location for my deck. Placed blocks in areas where they would go. Using basically 5 blocks per pallet, one on each corner and one in the center for better strength support. Started figuring out the exact spots for the blocks and pallets, now to place them in the ground for leveling. Started laying the pallets in place on the first row of blocks, and screwing them to each other with 2.5-inch deck screws. Going well so far, decided to start the second row of pallets, screwing them to each other. Repeated the steps for the third row of pallets. Thanks to my friends at Sunpower for donating the pallets. These pallets were for solar panels and built strong with extra boards on each side. Now I needed to seal the pallets with some polyurethane, so I soaked them with my 5-gallon bucket with a sprayer until it glistened. Pallets had a 1/2-inch lip due to the extra boards on the sides. I will be adding plywood down the center of each pallet. You'll see the plywood in a few frames from now. I added plywood to level the area for the decking material to be added. The pattern idea for the decking layout came from the study in my house. Thanks to my friend Clint, who owns Timber Gems, for donating the decking materials. Now you can see the plywood that I put down, and the pattern I used with the decking material looked nice, so I went with it. Timber Gems used to be in Newington, they have moved and are now located in Bloomfield. Continuing on with the pattern, it started coming out nicely. Finished squaring off to the deck edges, leaving it just the ends. Happy with the design so far. On each end of the deck, there needed something else. I'm going to leave the ends for seating that I will make with pallets as well. The pallets will butt right up next to the decking boards and be screwed into the deck. I placed some spare plywood sheets on the ends of the deck. It looked nice enough for now until I make the pallet furniture.
Alright, that was kind of a couple different days actually, but it's like I said, it was definitely a different video than we're used to seeing. You didn't get to actually see the work being done, but you see the project of it going through, and you know how it was a very laborious job. And it's not done. We're going to start building the chairs and stuff, the pallet furniture after. So that's coming too. That'll be a part two of it, so stay tuned for that video coming out soon. But yeah, that was a deck built out of free materials. It cost me a total of like $54 in deck screws. Oh, and I can't forget, I had to buy the polyurethane as well. So yeah, that's a little bit of a cost as well. Yeah, that's not cheap. But yeah, deck screws and polyurethane. That's all it cost me. Like I said, the lumber, or the pallets were free, and the decking material was free. You know, but possibly gonna put some artificial turf around the edges and, you know, around the walkways area, so it's not gonna be stepping on dirt and stuff like that. So that's another time coming. But yeah, this is just about building a deck for real inexpensive. Obviously, if it was free. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe, comment and share. Hit that notification bell so you get these videos when they come out. As always, I appreciate your support, and until next time, peace.